is using drones to map our barrier islands before and after Hurricane Ian.
As NBC2's Evan Dean found out, it could hold the key to building back stronger than ever before.
When you think of drones, you usually think of ones like this, ones that shoot video. But some drones can do so much more than that. And in this case, they can even help our communities build back stronger after the storm.
On the north side of Fort Myers Beach, months after it hit, the natural landscape still looks unlike before.
If you look here, you can see these kind of shallower pan areas that look a little bit deeper.
But to learn exactly how different our coast is after Ian.
Just connecting the batteries right now. All right, this is our launch position.
It takes more than just our eyes. Take off with FGCU's research team. They're using this drone equipped with a laser to map our coast, everywhere from Captiva to here above Fort Myers Beach to Naples.
LIDAR is a radar technology that sends a radar signal down to the surface. That radar signal bounces off the surface, comes back to the detector, and that gives you the topography. So we can actually get a good sense as to how the beach is shaped and how that shape has changed.
Soon after, we're on campus.
The hotter colors are highs, the colder colors are lows.
And back with Professor Mike Savarese, who shows us data they have so far. Here's Sanibel, both before and after Ian.
But the outcoming surge, the returning water, actually did more devastation.
Here next is Lover's Key State Park.
And then when you go from the pre to the post, you can see Lover's Key was just hammered before the storm.
And here is Fort Myers Beach.
Here you can see the development of those surge channels. Here's Estero Boulevard, and these channels are bumping right up against the road. There's a lot of loss of sediment here.
Savarese says there are clear-cut takeaways. Dunes on the coast are key.
The pre and post LIDAR looks no different.
And beaches with wider dune fields did best during Ian.
The further we set back development, the more space we put between the Gulf of Mexico and development, the more dune ridges we preserve, okay, the greater the resilience the coast has.
These students are helping with the research.
So this curve is post-Ian, and this curve is pre-Ian.
Another takeaway from their work is that cutting paths into dunes can be harmful. Just look at the before and after aerial here.
But knowing that I can make this difference is pretty nice.
Justin Wilder is among the students on the project. For him, the work is personal. His family lost their home on Sanibel to the storm. He's motivated by those he knows who lost everything.
That was their home. That's where they lived. They went to the beach every day. They were within walking distance of the beach. That was their livelihood. And to hopefully rebuild the beaches stronger and give the city the exact data that they would need to do that, I think that means a lot to me.
And that's the hope in all this, that the work can help our coastal communities impacted most.
To learn from a storm and rebuild the coast so it has a greater resilience capacity, so the next time the damage isn't as severe, there isn't as much loss of life, loss of property, you know, that's important.